And welcome to the Kiyoshi Herbie Bagwell TV show. I am your host, Kiyoshi Herbie Bagwell. And once again, my lovely guest, Miss Natasha McDuffie.
Good morning.
We're always coming to you guys direct. We also are on YouTube Live. Go to Soundview Studio A on YouTube. That is Soundview Studio A on YouTube. We are now branching out. So the six-figure viewers that I had are now in the seven figures. Look at God. Don't look at me, just look at God. But I want you all to really share this video. Those that are watching on social media, I want you to share this video. This is about identity. Mm. When you know who you are, then you know who you are not. And once again, good morning, Miss Natasha.
Good morning.
Wonderful, wonderful guest of mine. We've known each other for years. She has beautiful daughters, and they're all just lively and vibrant, and they are blessed, and they're all doing better than they think. Miss Natasha, identity.
Yes.
What's going on with that?
Identity. Mm-hmm. I'm going to give you three different scenarios, and this is what hit me so hard, knowing who you are. The first, and I was just speaking to Kiyoshi earlier, just giving a little background of it, but I was driving, and I see this woman, and you knew she just had a hard life, and you knew by the attire, but the bruises and the veins and the stumbling, I wanted to almost get out of my car and tell her, this is not the end, this is not who you are. And then what was ironic was later on I had saw another person, like at a gas station, this one was elevated in the bruising, the marks. You just knew it was just really hard for her. And there was just no hiding it. But then I went to go pick up a delivery. And I saw this little boy and he asked me name, gave him name. He was just so confident. You saw his siblings on the side. And he was saying what the order was, and he looked like the little manager. He had to be maybe 8, 9 years old. But I saw his parents watching him. And so I sat in my car to wait for the order, and the little girl came out, and it hit me that that's how God sees us. He is watching us. That little boy had identity. He knew one day I'm going to own this business of my father's, but right now he was in training.
Right.
And you could see the proudness in the father's eyes as he was cooking. But he knew his father was looking and listening and watching, you know, from a distance while he was cooking. And then he said, your order will be ready. And I'm going, what confidence in this young little man. And you see the pride in the father's eyes looking like, it's my son. And the little girl, his sister and the daughter, and they're just following suit because I saw the future self. They knew who they were. They knew who their father was and is. And they just knew in the long haul. And he was just writing. It looked like he was taking down orders, but he was actually doing homework.
Right.
But he said, it'll be ready. And I saw three different scenarios. The first woman was just battered and beaten. And God had said, he put in my heart, he says, you see this on the outside, right? But many people are walking like that with the bruises and the marks on the inside of the lie of the enemy.
Oh, absolutely.
To come, kill, steal, and destroy. To remove who you were destined to be, to try to rewrite your destiny, which he can't do that. He has no authority to do that, but we can give it away. And I was thinking, and then I'll pass it to Kiyoshi. In the 4 years, I realized that a lot of this solitude I have and had built me up to grow. Now, a disclaimer. Whether you believe in Christ or not, if you are a woman, if you're married, been divorced, have children, if you're a man, we can relate. There's something relatable. And let me tell you something. You were created for something more. But the way of the world that will rob you. Now, we can see these women on the outside. We like, yeah, we label them.
Right.
But what about the people, the men and women, who look like that on the inside, but on the outside, it's a different appearance. They show something different. But on the inside, they're battered, they're bruised, they're stumbling, they're hurting. So he said, let's remind people so that they can remind their children who you are and whose you are. Who are you and whose you are? Let's turn on the lights and let's unmask the true enemy that's robbing and killing and ultimately trying to get to your seeds, your legacy.
Outstanding. Outstanding opener for you, Natasha.
Thank you, Lord.
In Ecclesiastes, it says several times, is a time to smile, is a time to die, is a time to say, hell, there's 28 times, but there's never a time to quit. Hmm. And when you read Ecclesiastes, you'll understand that there's a time for everything. Hmm. But there's also a time to sit and listen. Hmm. And the listening skill, and once again, I have to brag on my host here, the listening skill that she has, I hope to one day attain that. Hmm. Because her listening skill is amazing. But you said so much just about knowing who you are.
Yeah.
Let me just take a couple steps back.
Yeah.
When you are going through what you're going through, God is going through it with you. If God woke you up this morning and you are at the sound of my voice and you're at the sound of Miss Natasha's voice, that means that God woke you up this morning for his divine purpose and his divine purpose only. It wasn't the iPhone, it wasn't the droid, it wasn't the dog, it wasn't your significant other. It's because God has a divine purpose for you. That's why there shouldn't be any haters in the world. Mm. There shouldn't be any haters because God gave us all gifts.
Yes.
I was talking about that just this morning to my boys out there in California who are going through it. Praying for you to stay to California.
Amen.
Looks like we're going to another lockdown. All the masks are mandatory now. But the point that I'm making is that you have to understand this. Your blessing is already ready. God is preparing you for the blessing.
Amen.
You're not waiting on God. God is waiting on you. Mm-hmm. I learned that firsthand. When you see athletes, this is just the best way to have a parallel and have that paradigm shift. And I want you to hear me out. When you are watching athletes, I don't care if it's gymnastics, I don't care if it's badminton, I don't care if it's volleyball, boxing, football, baseball, any type of a sport that requires one on against one, there's a level of confidence that athlete, he or she is going to show. They're gonna show you some confidence. They're gonna have a look on their face like, I belong here. The race is already won. I guess I go out there and just have to show it now. Mm. All the years of preparation, all the months, all the weeks, all the days, all the eating right, all of the sacrifices, that confidence comes out and it exudes like a nice perfume or a cologne. It's not being boisterous, it's not being arrogant. Those who view confidence as arrogant, I have to question those people on their self-esteem. I have to question those people about their own life. What are you not doing that's giving you confidence? Mm. Before my feet even hit the ground, I talked to the one almighty one who woke me up, the divine one. I talked to him first, and it seems like all the bumps and the bruises and the soreness that I have, it all seems just to dissipate after I pray to the one up above. It really does. So when you know who you know who you are not. And those on social media that are watching us right now, I want you to share this right now.
Amen.
Because there are so many people who are having confidence issues, integrity issues. Oh, that's another show, Miss Natasha, who are having issues of identity, as this show is now so appropriately and timely named identity. See, I know who I am. There's not a person from a certain ethnicity, a culture, a color that can tell me who I am. I already know who I am. I'm a child of the Most High God.
Amen.
And I graduated and become a man of God. I'm a warrior for God. I liken myself to King David in the Bible. No, not his off stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But King David would always inquire to the word of the Lord. Should I take this camp? Should I attack that enemy? Should I conquer this? He would always ask first, showing humility.
Yeah.
Before mm-hmm. my feet hit the ground, I ask God, what is my assignment today? What path of direction, Father God, do you want me to take? And I get quiet.
Yeah.
Because God can't talk to you if there's chaos and noise all around you all the time. So people ask me all the time, Kiyoshi Bagwell or Herbie Bagwell or Reverend Bagwell, how do you do it? How do you stay so together? You're knocking on 60, you're still producing muscle. How do you do it? It's by the sheer love and mercy of the Lord. My karate school looks absolutely beautiful. If you walk in there, you walk in the back room, there's some new additions. You got to go check it out now, Mr. Taj. Some new additions. Don't look at me, look at God. And I need people right now, even on social media. I know I'm breaking the record, but I need you to share this video. And those who are at home, I want you to hear me, because you know when I lean up, I'm like E.F. Hutton, I mean business. When you are going about your regular day, if you haven't gotten the first bread, the bread of God, the bread of life, if you haven't gotten the first fruits of God, mm-hmm. people can subscribe to you, anything they want to subscribe to you, because you are going to just believe anything. Mm. There's not a person living that can tell me who and what I am. You can try to psychoanalyze me, you're going to get your feelings hurt. You can try to guess how I'm feeling, you're going to be wrong. Because whatever I'm portraying out here, it's absolute joy and peace on the inside. Because a man of my caliber and a man of my integrity, a man of my status and a man of my skill set on the inside, if I choose to, can be very, very decisively in the negative, but I choose to be positive, because joy and sadness cannot occupy the same space twice. It can't do it. So I need you all at home that are watching the Kiyoshi Herbie Bagwell TV show, understand this, that before your feet hit the ground in the morning, just say, thank you, God.
Yep.
And then ask God, God, how can I love you more? And God, more of you and less of me in my life. And then hit the floor running. And that's what you have to do. You have to give your first everything to God in the morning. That's what we do every single morning. And we mm-hmm. come to you on a Friday morning with coffee in hand. And this one's talking to somebody on the phone trying to calm them down. And I'm walking in here with my Dolphins cup. Y'all see my Dolphins cup. Y'all see it. That's it, Miami Dolphins, baby. Y'all see it. And I'm just so full of joy and I'm happy. And I get to come to my TV show. Mm-hmm. I get to go to my karate school. I get to sit here with this beautiful lady on my TV show as my guest. Don't say you gotta go to work and you gotta pick up the kids and you gotta go to, no. You get to do that. And I'm gonna leave you with this. There is somebody in the hospital right now mm-hmm. who is down to their last breath.
Yeah.
And they would swap places with you literally in a heartbeat mm-hmm. and you may think that your situation right now is absolutely horrible, spiritually, mentally, physically, relationally, or even financially, but there are people in this world who had your same situation and they won with it.
That's right.
So stop complaining, because if you pray and then you complain, you just wiped out the prayer, because now where's your faith? Faith without works is dead. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Hmm. That's what that is. Miss Natasha.
Amen. Wow. Amen. You know, we come because, you know, we've been through and you know, we share. But the reality is, you know, I want to encourage you. You are fearfully, wonderfully made. When you are knit, there is a plan. The enemy has a plot to kill and steal, and you can see it, and it's not quick, it's gradual. Oh. What we see walking the streets, preach. Those that are drinking, those are this, those are addicted, there's this. Listen, there's an addiction for everything, to be honest, and here's the thing, our identity and who we are requires us to be still and to quiet the voices, the noise that everybody has that. We're always having to block out these sudden thoughts that come in our minds all the time. We're always having to do that. So my thing is that it is imperative for us to, when you get up in the morning or look in the mirror, I want you to start practicing saying, and you know, it's not about whether you feel like it. It's a matter of, he always says about consistency. So it's, you're wonderfully made. He always says something good's going to happen to me. Always. Something's good's going to happen through me. Do you know that my children now hear that? Because I took that. I listened. I said, what a way to speak affirmation. Not because we are hoping, but well, our confidence is, no, we have something to offer. And I want you to practice talking in the mirror. You're fearfully, wonderfully made. There's no weapon formed against you. And I know for some of me, like, what is she talking about? There is nothing that the enemy plots against you that will overthrow the plans of God. Amen. And that's why one of God's plan is for us to sit and talk,
yes,
to reach you, that will reach somebody else, that will tell somebody else, that will tell somebody else. So because he can see what you're going through
all the time.
He could see. And even if you wear your best face, the wounds and the hurt, the identity, I believe the identity is ripped from youth. I believe that somewhere along the line there was a wound, and it started small.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't this big gradual thing, but it was one little disappointment to this, to that, and it's usually connected to those that are closest to us. So as time goes on, there's not so much of an expectancy to see something come to fruition.
Right.
So then when we think about this big God, we think, oh yeah, you're there, or yeah, there's somebody there, but you know, he's all too powerful, but he's not really concerned about me. He's just That's a lie.
Right.
That is an absolute lie. And the enemy comes to rip our identity away and to cause division.
Mm-hmm.
To cause division. So I just, when I saw those three scenarios, but when I saw that little one be so confident,
mm-hmm,
I could see the pride. That's what the Lord wants. That's what the Lord feels for us. And so I just want you to know, if there are wounds or there are hurts, it's time to buckle down, be still, and let's start addressing those. This is why we talk about certain subjects. This is why we talk about certain subjects. We're sitting here giving from the crushing oil, from the crushing. What we're giving to you is precious oil.
Yeah.
But not because we weren't crushed.
Yeah.
Not because we weren't crushed.
Yes.
So when we share this with you, we're opening up our chest and saying, because we're revealing the Revelations 12:11,
yes,
that we've overcome by the blood of the Lamb, because it had it been our own,
right,
self, I don't even know. I don't even know the decisions we would have. I don't know how we would have handled enemies.
Right.
It would have not been probably pretty.
I love
but
that.
Praise God. Overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. We're testifying that we have been tested and still get tested to see, are we really resolved?
Ooh, every day.
Are you really, is what you're saying, are you really resolved?
Every day.
Because people are watching.
Amen. Wow.
wow.
This is my chick right here. This is my spiritual chick.
Well, he spars
chick.
It. He's like, come on.
You know, you said a whole lot there. I'm going to go, again, take a step back to the crushing. And I have to say this man's name. I just have to give him his props. The Bishop T.D. Jakes talks about the crushing. He had a book that he named Sore, but he wanted to call it the crushing. It's in the uncomfortable stages in life, mm-hmm, that we show growth. It's in the, God doesn't care about your comfort. He cares about your character. So when you are going through the crushing, when your daughter comes to you and says, Daddy, I'm, oh, or Mommy, I'm, oh, we won't go there right now. Or your son says something that's crushing, or you've been working at a job for 15, 20 years and they fire you or they let you go, that's the crushing. Or if you're in a relationship and someone cheats or something negative happens, it's the crushing. Or you go to the doctor's office for a routine checkup and you get some bad news, that's the crushing.
Mm-hmm.
Or you own, if you're a business owner like myself, and then here comes 2020 and the lockdown, and you go through that transitional period, that's called the crushing. Mm-hmm. But it's in the crushing that we find out the true strength of God.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it happens, it's in the crushing. And if you don't understand that it's in the uncomfortable moments of life, that's where your growth happens.
You want to repeat that again?
Yes, ma'am. When you are going through the crushing, the uncomfortable moments of life, that's when your growth happens. People think they're buried. No, you're not buried. You're planted. When you put a seed into the ground and it's cold and it's wet and it's damp,
and it's
that
dark.
Seed then, and it's dark, it's uncomfortable. That's why people say, who are true saints, they will say to you, when you're alone, watch your thoughts. Because the idle mind is a what? Devil's playground. So watch your thoughts when you are alone, because your thoughts become words, your words become your actions can become a way of life. Yep. Okay? And it's always pride before what? Destruction.
Can you say that one more time? I had a discussion.
Amen.
Pride before what?
Pride before before destruction. You have to watch what you're saying.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, now about the conflict and the consistency that she was talking about. Yes, I'm about consistency.
Yeah.
I own a very successful business, praise God.
Thank you.
I own a very successful business, and now I have successful businesses in the plural because I was faithful. Do not despise the times of small beginnings.
Mm-mm.
I was successful, and I was grateful and consistent when I just had just one business. And God saw my consistency. He saw how grateful I was with the smalls that I had, and now God has increased me. That's how it works. That's how it works. You have to be grateful when you have a business and you only have like a handful of members.
Mm-hmm.
You treat those members like they're platinum. Gold is nothing. You treat them kids, those members like it's platinum. Because when you treat them like this platinum, God sees you. God sees that you're happy with what you have and that you're not miserable about what you don't have.
Amen.
I'll repeat that. Be happy and grateful for what you have and what you can do.
That's right.
And stop being miserable and unhappy with what you don't have and what you can't do.
Yeah.
I've always been that person. And so now, here comes the conflict. It's not that we want conflict all the time with people.
Nope.
But if you have a problem with me, come talk to me. Don't talk to my neighbors. There's a song back in the Saviors, back in the center says, don't ask my neighbor, come to me. Come on, don't be afraid.
Hey. I love it.
So don't ask my neighbor. If you have a problem, come to me.
Yeah, I agree.
Because conflict delayed is conflict magnified.
That's correct.
I'll say it again. Conflict delayed is conflict magnified. Now you have a conflict because you don't want to talk about it.
Sorry.
Now you have a war inside yourself.
Yes.
And we can't look this good, girl, if we have a conflict and we have a war inside ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not having that.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a few more minutes, Miss Natasha. How can people get in contact with you?
Yeah, so transformed mind, renewed spirit at gmail.com. Transformed mind, renewed spirit at gmail.com. You can also Facebook me, send me a private DM. You can do it like that. I really like a messenger that you can call or you can do a video. I love to chat. I usually do most of the stuff on the phone and talking, but you can email me. And in case of an emergency, there is help. You can call me at 203-526-9047.
Outstanding. You all know how to get in contact with me. Call me, tweet me, fax me, Facebook me, Instagram me,
yep.
TikTok. Once again, all those on social media, we love you. We're going to always spend a few minutes after my show ends in a few, but I definitely want you guys to hang out. But share these videos.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone at home watching the Kiyoshi Herbie Bagwell TV show, I just want to tell you all, thank you so much for your patronage, for your subscriptions. Come on down to Soundview TV if you own a business. They are phenomenal in helping you advertise your business through marketing, advertising, and promotion. They have wonderful, wonderful people here at Soundview TV, right located right here in Stratford. And also, too, they now have increased their viewership. We're on Soundview Studio A on YouTube. Once again, Soundview Studio A on YouTube. And you can watch the shows, you know, past and whatever. It's an absolute wonderful place. The studios are beautiful. The people mm-hmm. are professional. Yes, it's air conditioned. Everything in here is very nice. But on behalf of Natasha McDuffie and myself, Kiyoshi Herbie Bagwell, I want you guys to listen up really quick. I want Miss Natasha to give about a good minute of prayer. Then we're going to end the TV show. And once again, keep God first place and all will be well with you. Miss Natasha, 1 minute.
Father, we just thank you for this time. Father, remind us of who we are in you and whose we are to you. In the name of Jesus, we're fearfully and wonderfully made. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. God, we thank you for this day. Lord, any sin or iniquity, we just leave it at the cross. Hallelujah. This is the day that you have made. We rejoice Hallelujah. And are glad in it. In Jesus' name, amen.
In Jesus' name. So all those at the sound of my voice, I want you to remember one thing, and I'm going to challenge you right now. I challenge you all to take a few minutes in the morning and a few minutes at night. Yeah. Pray and read scripture when everyone is still asleep in the morning, and pray and read scripture at night when everyone is asleep. Find that nice quiet space, that quiet spot in your home. If you have to go into your car and do it, because wherever you are, that's where God shall be. When two or more are in agreement, that's where God shall be. I know God is here every Friday morning. He is with us always. We are blessed in the city, and we are blessed in the field. We are blessed on our going out and blessed on our coming in. So keep one thing in mind, that God is with you always. Again, on behalf of Natasha McDuffie, I am Kiyoshi Herbie Bagwell. Thank you for watching the Kiyoshi Herbie Bagwell. Be blessed. Thank you, and good night. I get it. I get it.